Hello, folks, kids, grandparents, whatever you are, YouTubians, animals. It's your buddy Alex here, and today we're going to talk about layered editing. It's one of my favorite features inside of Bitwig Studio 2, and I think you're going to like it. It's one of the things that makes Bitwig special, and it might get a little heavy, but if you don't learn features like this, then why are you even using Bitwig? Okay? All right, let's dig in. Okay, so there's many reasons why you would want to layer your audio tracks to edit one in comparison to the other. The first that I can think of is if you want to lock in your bass to your drums or vice versa. Maybe you want to edit your drum track to match your bass track. There could be a bazillion reasons. Okay, but I'm going to show you how to do it. First of all, there's two kind of different ways that you layered audio. One I call layered, the other I call stacked. When it's in regards with audio, if I double click this and change the bottom screen over to the audio editing feature, and I press shift tab to bring it up into full screen, no problem, same as it always is. Right now, I am effectively editing my bass track. And here you got your clips, your stretch, onsets, all that stuff that we've all grown to know and love. And nothing much is different there. But now if I come down here and I click the layers, it even looks like stacks of paper layered on top of each other, and I click it. Now what do you notice? Okay, well firstly, this has changed. This is all the audio tracks that are inside your project, okay? Notice how there's no MIDI tracks. Well, there is, but they're hybrid tracks. They have audio on them, and therefore, they've made the cut to here, okay? We can turn things on and off. We can bring them in and out of view by clicking the little eye, just like that. See, if I only have my bass guitar selected, it's just like having the same screen that I did before. The second thing you'll notice is here, there's no clips, audio events, stretch or onsets. That's now in a drop-down menu, but it's all the same. It's not, you know, it shouldn't be too confusing. And I call this stacking audio for editing, okay? Because it's not really layering. If I was layering, then you would see this in behind that, but wouldn't that get confusing, right? Like they're both audio waveforms. And so if I were to put this on top of that, it would just be a slew of audio waveforms and you wouldn't know which one is which and it wouldn't really help you. So instead they stack it. So now there's my guitar solo and it's right on top of my bass. And now I can edit my bass in comparison to my guitar solo or vice versa, right? And you can see I did not quantize my guitar solo. I personally don't want to do that. I kind of like leaving the soul in there a little bit as much as I can. Okay, so that's fine, but that doesn't help me edit my MIDI drum track to my bass at all because, well, my drums are MIDI and my bass is obviously recorded audio. So I could do a couple things. I could go back here. I could select these and I could bounce them out so that they're audio. And then I can go into here, select that bounce, and edit them on top of each other like that. But there's an even easier way, and I'm going to show you that right now. Down here in the corner where you selected the layered thing, and when you click that, two more things popped up. Right now, I'm on audio, and it looks like an audio waveform. It looks like a transient of like a drum or something like that. And that's telling you that you're in the audio waveform, and I call it stacking. So if you click that, you're basically stacking audio, and now you can add in all the things in your project that contain audio information, and you can edit them just like that. You can switch it over to stretch, and now everything is in stretch mode, and you can kind of go and stretch all your tracks at once rather than being down here with this turned off, and now you're just doing one at a time, okay? Turn this back on. Okay, so let's get back to editing the MIDI on top of my bass guitar. So now I go over here and I click MIDI. So now everything is turned into MIDI. These are all my MIDI tracks. And again, you'll see here is a list of all my MIDI tracks, excluding anything audio. And there you have it. So now if I wanted to, I could go and edit my MIDI this way and everything works the same just as it normally would. And when you edit MIDI, nothing in that sense changes. Let me turn this off, just clean it up a bit. Okay, and the only difference is now all the MIDI is stacked. But I'm gonna come over here and I'm just gonna unfold the audio. But now, if I want a background of a certain audio track, I click here, and this is choosing what background do I want. So here's all my audio tracks. In this case, I said I wanted to edit my drums on top of my bass, and that's always a good idea because they gotta lock in. That's your rhythm section. So I click bass guitar and show the bass in behind. I can't edit the bass here. I can't edit the bass here because I can't physically grab it. This is on MIDI mode, and therefore we can only edit MIDI. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and hide everything. Except my one drum kit. There we go. Now we can zoom in. And there, now I can edit my drums to conform to my bass. Notice how my bass is often a little bit late. I do that because I think it adds a decent groove. And if you record any rock bands, you'll know that the bass is kind of always a little bit behind the beat on purpose, you put it right on beat and then shift it all a little bit off beat and tell me what you like better. It's music, so you can do whatever you want. But in my case, I like it offset a little bit. But see, now I can edit these notes. Let me turn off the sound. I can edit these notes and I can move them around. And it's just exactly the same as editing MIDI any other time. The only difference is now I'm looking at the bass guitar's waveform in behind there. Say I want to switch it to the guitar solo. Well, there you go. No problem. You know, now you've got like a guitar solo watermark in behind your drums. And that's pretty cool too. And that's super handy. Now, I could choose none, so there's no background. And I can just turn on like my xylophones, like polysynth here, my sub bass, and zoom out. And now you see it's stacked up my MIDI data. And this is almost the better way to edit your MIDI. For example, let me turn these off. If I just have my sub bass on, I can see now where all my sub basses are. Put it in fold, and there we go. That's all tracks of my sub bass, okay? And you can see, are they on the same octave? Do they all match the same length? Are they all placed the same way? Because you want your sub bass to play everything in unison with one another, right? Like, you don't want chords and stuff in your sub bass. Well, maybe you do, but I didn't. And so now here I can see that it's all layered differently. If you're gonna do that, I would say probably color these differently. For example, press Option I, bring that up, and turn this one, I don't know, green or whatever that is, yellow. Looks like highlighter, actually. And now you can tell that this is the one that you're editing, and you can see that it all lines up. Let's go back to blue, keep things, you know, in order. And that's really basically it. Again, you still have all your features. You can edit your velocities. You can edit, you know, these whatever features you choose here, your automation. You can turn on and off the sound. You can add in a background. Let's see, bass guitar. Go back to unfold. And so on and so forth, okay? All the zooming and scrolling rules still apply. If you hold a control option and scroll left and right on your mouse pad or mouse wheel, then you can do that, and up and down while holding control and option zooms in and out, okay? So it's basically all the same stuff. The only difference is that if you get familiar with layering your audio like this and you edit it that way, it'll save you from having to flip back and forth to editing that one and then editing that guy and then looking at your bass and then looking at your whatever xylophone, you know? And that's basically it. I guess it didn't get too heavy, really. It's just important to realize that if you're gonna edit MIDI, you're gonna do it on a bunch of tracks, well, you might as well hit the layer function, select all the tracks you plan on editing, and just do them all at once while you can see all the other ones, and you can just kind of scroll through and do it that way, okay? All right, guys, I hope that clears it up a little bit for you. If you have any more questions or comments, definitely let me know. Oh, the last thing I'm gonna say, is when you're in clip mode. Clip mode's a little bit weird, isn't it? Look, the audio disappeared, right? Isn't that strange? Go back here, click track. Look, now the audio is back. Clip mode. Oh, wait. Yeah, see? It's, like, gone. I'm not really sure about that. Actually, if you have a solution to that, let me know. I'm going to fiddle with that because that just seems strange to me. You know what? If I click this, hold command, and then select that. Yeah, that's bizarre. That is so weird. Well, anyway, work in track mode, and you can layer your audio, and that's the way to go. Okay? All right. I'll talk to you guys later. Ciao.